So welcome guys, GATE exam is near, so let's start some discussion on jet propulsion and we'll complete the series with this. So what are the things we are going to cover in this series of jet propulsion? So first of all, I'll teach you the jet engine completely, and then I will teach you the separate bodies, whatever they are assembled in the jet engine. So first question comes, why there is a need of a jet engine? So just understand in this way. Suppose you have a balloon and this is filled with the air and it is closed. Now if you will open this exit portion, then all the airs will smoothly go outside with certain velocity. So because of air molecules, the molecules will be having mass and they have some velocity. It means what? They are coming out from the balloon with certain momentum. Momentum is equal to mass into velocity. Okay, so just because of momentum transfer, the same amount of momentum will be transferred to the balloon, and balloon is having its own mass, then it will be achieving same momentum. So mass of the balloon and velocity of the balloon, what we don't know, and here velocity of the molecules and all the mass together of the molecules. So you can say something like whatever momentum is coming out, same momentum will be conserved and that momentum will be transferred to the balloon, right? So according to the mass and velocity, the same momentum balloon has to achieve, so this balloon will go in this direction. So I am trying to say that when something goes outside like this, the reaction will be like this. This is only the Newton's third law also. Next point, if you have this kind of concept, then if you attach something here, suppose you are attaching a big body here, okay, then if this part is moving in this direction, then this part, this mass increased because of this body, so definitely velocity will be slow because same momentum you are getting. So this body will go in this direction. Now consider this body as the fuselage and the wing and another part. Suppose this is the fuselage and this is the tail and this is the wing, and this part you consider as a jet engine. So suppose I am drawing a small jet engine here. So when the hot gases will come out from the jet engine, this jet engine will try to go in this direction. This jet engine will try to go in this direction, but because it is attached with the wing, so the air, the wing and the entire body will move in this direction. Then because the wing is moving in this direction, so this wing will experience relative wind over the wing, and because of this relative motion of the wind and the wing will experience the lift. Okay. So two types of motion will happening at a time. Lift means the airplane will go upward, and at the same time, because of this thrust, air will go in this direction. So you will be able to reach from one point to another point. Okay, so this is why we have to construct a strong jet engine, and which should be able to produce sufficient thrust. Now I am saying sufficient thrust. What is the meaning of sufficient thrust? Sufficient thrust means, in different types of aircraft, we have to accomplish different types of need. I mean, some kind of aircraft can be just for commercial purpose, for transport purpose, which is definitely under commercial, fighter planes. So we need a engine which should be able to perform this job. Okay, so if you want the gases coming out from the engine, so suppose what will you do? Suppose you have a jet engine, okay, and you want simply that gases should come out, okay, with some high speed. But suppose you are not providing anything in between, no devices are attached, no compressor, no turbine, no combustion chamber, no diffuser, no nozzle. So what will happen? With whatever speed gases will enter, with same speed they will go out also, correct? Same speed they will go out. Now question is, do you want that? With what speed air is entering, same speed air should go out? No, we don't want that. Because in that case, we'll be not be getting sufficient thrust this side, correct? We'll be not be getting sufficient thrust. So because we don't have sufficient thrust, so what should we do? So somehow, if we attach a nozzle here, then what will happen? Definitely at the exit, speed will increase, correct? So if speed will increase, then we will be getting more momentum here. Then that much momentum will be transferred to this body, and as according to the mass of the body, and will be getting the velocity into this body, correct? Or you can see we'll be getting little thrust. But definitely, how long nozzle you will provide? Because of friction on the way, you will be having some losses, right? So maybe you are thinking that velocity will increase, but maybe because of friction irreversibility, the gas molecule will stop in between somewhere, correct? So this is not the case. So we can't extend, we can't just give the nozzle. But suppose you have given the nozzle of certain length, you can give one more thing, okay? You can do little more modification. What? You can increase the pressure of the gas. Then more pressurized will gas, more pressurized gas will travel to more distance, correct? So to pressurize the gas, you need some device which will pressurize the gas, whatever gas is coming from here. So that device we say as compressor. So you need a compressor, and you know, this is a typical diagram of compressor in every jet engine, we draw like this only. So, or you can simply say this is a compressor. You can simply say this is the compressor. So, but the typical diagram is like this. We say this diagram as compressor. Okay. So in this kind of diagram of compressor, when the air will enter, this compressor will run, okay? And after running, it will convert it. So whatever, I mean to say, when the compressor will run, it will transfer its work to the this thing, whatever air is coming. So when compressor is running, it will transfer the work to the fluid, I mean to the air, and that air will get compressorized, okay? You can say pressurized. So compress the air. So when you will compress the air, then volume of the air will decrease for sure, because the molecules now, they don't have need of to occupy more space, they will occupy less space because now they are pressurized and they have little volume. So with the this is the idea to compress the air. So when we are compressing the air, after that air will move to the next part, okay? So idea is compressed air, okay? Consider like this, you have three chambers, and here you have gas with certain pressure and temperature. So consider room pressure and room temperature. Now here you have some pressure and temperature, but this is room temperature, but pressure is somewhat higher than this. Consider third chamber where you have pressure and temperature, and this pressure is very high and temperature is very, very high, okay? So now make a hole in all the three chambers. So what do you think? From which hole air will come out very fast? From this hole, correct? Because here you have more temperature and more pressure, means here you have more pressure energy as well as more internal energy in the molecules. So both, with the help of both the energies, you will be getting kinetic energy outside, correct? So by using the compressor, you have increased the pressure of the pressure of the gas. Now we'll be using a combustion chamber. So when this pressurized air will enter to the combustion chamber, the combustion will happen here. It means what? I will send some fuel, and already these air molecules will be having oxygen present in the air. So that oxygen will be helpful to burn these fuels coming out from the system. And in the combustion chamber, complete combustion process will happen. Because of this combustion process, the heat will generate, and that because of that heat, whatever gases are coming, now they are very, very hot. So now these hot gases and high pressurized gases, because of the temperature, because of the combustion, again some pressure will increase. In real life, definitely some pressure will increase, but in ideal case, we don't consider that there is no pressure increment in this combustion chamber. Only pressure increment we consider here and diffuser section. Anyway, I will explain about diffuser, but try to understand that at this stage, we have achieved more pressure and more temperature. So that more pressure and more temperature, gas will go further. Now question comes. In a typical jet engine, we have a turbine here. But why there is need of turbine? Directly we can send the gas without turbine. But point is, how this compressor will run to compress these gases? Because we have to run this compressor, so we need a turbine. So suppose whatever air is coming now with more pressure and more temperature, that air, I will use some amount of energy I will use from that air to run the turbine. And once the turbine will start running, I will connect a rod here with the compressor. So by some mechanical losses, some energy, some RPM I will transfer to the compressor. So that compressor will run, and then gases will go to this, and these gases will be hot, and then they will go to the turbine. After this, no need of add anything. Okay, then just I will add a nozzle, and definitely pressure energy will convert into kinetic energy into nozzle, means gases will expand very fast, like here in case of balloon, right? Now point is, if you want to run the compressor, sorry, you are running the compressor to compress these incoming gases. Okay, but you see, when you will be having more and more and more gases going this side with very high speed, this engine will go in this direction with somewhat very high speed. So in same way, the air will enter in this with very high speed. So it can damage your compressor and compressor blades. And once very high speed air will cross the compressor, it will come to the combustion chamber. Then combustion will not happen properly, because combustion cannot happen at supersonic, hypersonic speed in practical now. The date when you are watching the video, maybe in future it is possible. Definitely people are working. So now see, so we need to perform subsonic combustion, correct? So because we want subsonic combustion, so whatever air is entering from here, we have to reduce the speed, correct? Reduce the velocity. We have to bring that higher speed to the subsonic region. So inlet section, design of inlet becomes very important here. That part, sometimes we say inlet or sometimes we say popularly diffuser. Now see, diffuser looks like this. In case of, if you want to decrease the speed of a subsonic air, you need this kind of model. And in this design, suppose here air is coming with 100 speed. So definitely once it will cross the diffuser, the speed will be less than 100. Consider 70 or 40 or whatever, it depends, you can apply continuity equation here and you can find out. So my point is, here I am explaining how jet engine works and why there is need of different devices, correct? So there are diffuser, or you say inlet, nozzle, or you say outlet. So inlet, outlet devices, they don't have any kind of moving part with that attached with them. There is no moving part, no rotating, moving means rotating part, there is no. But in case of compressor and turbine, these guys are rotating, right? So in case of combustion chamber, again, we don't have kind of rotating part, but the fuel is incoming here. Okay, fuel is coming here, and these fuels will mix with the incoming air, and then this process will happen. I hope I am able to deliver the idea. Now, one very important thing, guys, in the air, whatever air is coming, we have oxygen present. So suppose that oxygen, suppose we have 50 oxygen present in my example, I am considering 50 oxygen present. And suppose here some fuel I am supplying. So these 50 oxygens will reach to the combustion chamber. And to burn the fuel, whatever fuel we are bringing back here, suppose 30 oxygens are helpful to burn the fuel, and remaining 20 oxygen molecules will go out of the nozzle, right? So if you want to use these 20 also, because already after the turbine and before the nozzle, we have got sufficient pressurized air, okay, and little speed also, because after turbine somewhat air will expand, right? So just after combustion chamber itself, we have expansion started, okay? So these 20 oxygen molecules we can again use by introducing a device called afterburner, okay? So after turbine and before nozzle, or you can say after turbine in the nozzle, but it is not like in the nozzle, just after turbine we can introduce, there is another device called afterburner, AB, afterburner. What is the role of the afterburner? Afterburner will supply again some amount of fuel, and this fuel must be only that much only, that these 20 oxygen should be able to burn them. We can't supply more fuel here, correct? So we have a proper calculation that how much oxygen is remaining after the turbine. According to those many oxygens, we will supply our fuel, and that fuel will again burn. So again the speed will be higher. So this kind of afterburner procedure we attach in many jet engines. So when you will supply the when you will switch on the afterburner functionality, then you will be getting very high speed quickly. You know, sometimes we play car video games. So we have nitrogen something, and we press the nitrogen blue color button, then car will speed quickly, correct? So in same way, when we'll be using afterburner, then very fast speed will be achieving. So this kind of functionality is very helpful during takeoff or suppose fighter plane, one fighter plane is like this, one fighter plane is like this, and this fighter plane is running away from this fighter plane, and this fighter plane has to catch this, then it will switch on the afterburner and it will quickly catch this fighter plane. So that is the role of afterburner. So when you want sudden increment in speed, you can use the afterburner. So guys, I explained all the parts separately. Now the jet engine idea is completed. Now I have to teach you the technicality and numericals based on every single part. So here the next topic will be having properly TS diagram for all the things, HS diagram for all the things, and the numericals for all the things. And right now we are covering jet engine. After jet engine, we'll be having some other kind of engines, turbofan, turboprop. So these kind of engines definitely we'll be discussing here. Fine. And because see here we have turbine attached, so this will also fall, this you can also say that turbojet, because we have turbine here, correct? So turbojet engine. So under jet engine we have this is turbojet, then we have turbofan, turboprop, ramjet, pulse jet, blah blah things. So I hope all done. Okay, so wait for the next video, and next video will be based on proper things. And here when we are using compressor, so we can have two types of compressor. In jet engine we are using axial compressor, we can also use centrifugal compressor. So we have two types of compressors, axial and centrifugal, that we'll discuss. And then we'll discuss types of combustion chamber, grain types and all types of there. And then we have nozzle. So actually in case of nozzle, we have to discuss lot of things. This is very, very important. Fine. Okay. I think now all done. We should stop this topic. Fine. We'll meet in the next video.